So, hey, ladies and gents, welcome back to another video. This is our weekly update. This is Kazi, and I'm here with Saeed. So, Saeed, Hey, what's up, man? What have you been up to?
Not too well. We can see that the futures market just opened. We are seeing a huge gap down. We'll start off with the Nikkei as we're following the Far East, and then going to U.S. markets, we see the Dow has gapped down. What I mean by gap down, there's a huge difference between how the market opened up or closed from here to here. So we are already seeing 300 points lower. That being said, good thing is we don't have any positions. In fact, I have not been able to trade due to travels, and we've been somewhat changing our routine on how we can trade because we don't get enough screen time. And the fact that we want to start capturing larger moves, I don't think I've mentioned this in our videos, that we've taken out our principal money. Initially, when we started off, $500.
Wow, we did? Yeah.
Yep. January 1st, with our $500. February 10th, after the Tesla trade, I've decided to take off some profits off the table. In fact, I wanted to take off the entire principal capital that we started with. And now we are, this is all house money, what you can see, $541. Our equity curve has been somewhat steady. It's not been going up or down, and primarily because of me traveling, and we've not been able to sync to look at some of the trades. The trades that we took for this month has not been quite favorable. In fact, last week we've taken a trade, and I'd like to consider these trades more of, think of it as a tuition. The reason I say that, I've not been able to take trades because of my job and not being able to consistently get some screen time. One of the trade that we took was SPY. The plan was to ride this. We got in at 293. Stop was at $2. It was one contract. Ended up taking an $89 loss. We got stopped out immediately as soon as the market opened. Now, good thing is, because we had stop, we only lost $89. If we didn't have stop, the market went down as low as $1.67, which means we would have lost roughly on a single contract. You're good with math. How much was that?
I never passed math.
About $126 if we didn't have a stop. So that's about $84 difference. That means we would have had more loss. But good thing is, because we had stop and our tuition cost was only $89, which it didn't affect us. Now, I know we didn't cover this. We can certainly circle back on a video to discuss what is our multiple, but just to keep it simple for the folks who have no idea, like you, anything below 1R, it means that you're not risking, and the risk to reward is much safe, anything less than 1R. So our trade for this trade was 0.96, which was phenomenal. But of course, we got stopped out. You know, that's part of doing business. The second trade, we took a $100 loss. And again, I like to consider this a tuition cost. We bought this Nike. This was a much more longer term. The plan was to ride this out to 525 price target. We bought in at $3.93, one contract. And we got stopped out. And this was a 0.97R, which was good. Now, what I want to do, the goal is, now we want to trade. Our equity curve so far is good. You know, there's going to be times where you'll have consistent losses, small losses, will not affect the account. If you had losses, was my invitation. Where, let's switch this up, keep it simple. If you had losses and your equity curve was like this, that's bad. Because our equity curve is somewhat, it's flatline going down, which is fine. Our goal should be to slowly push our equity curve right back up where we belong. The goal is, I've switched up and became more aggressive in trading nothing but SPY. Now, because the futures market had opened up and we can see that everything will gap down tomorrow after market, after opening, I believe what we have here is the 20-day moving average and a 50-day moving average. We can circle back on educating the folks on what is a moving average and why we would use moving average, especially for the type of trading that we would do. My assumption is we would be seeing a gap down, and we might even see SPY opening around 330. And if that happens, that means we would be testing the 50-day moving average. If that actually happens, I would wait. Nothing to be done right now. What I want to see is market consolidating at a level where buyers come in, hold this area. If it holds, chances are this would be a support level. A lot of smart money would be watching, and we'll take a trade from there. And again, I'm traveling the entire month, so going forward, we will only trade SPY, and we want to get a more of a bigger picture. What I mean by this, if we were to get into this trade, we would want to ride this out on a weekly option where we would start off. Let's take hypothetically. There might be potential for us if we can take a trade. If it gaps down to maybe $2 or $3, of course, we want to wait until we get a confirmation. But this is just an example. We can ride a $2 contract to back to maybe $4, or even as high as $7, or even as high as $9, which means the profit target, all of the losses that we had, these small losses, we will surely go back and be able to ride back our equity curve back where we want it to belong, which is back to uptrend. So yeah, that's where we stand, and that is the update for this week.
All right, so yeah, that sounds promising. You have covered a lot, and since we are both traveling, we're on the go. The sound might be a little off, but I think the audience can bear with us for this. We will definitely come back to our normal usual kind of videos pretty soon. But again, that's basically it, right?
That is it. That's correct. Yeah.
All right. So thank you so much for watching, ladies and gents. This has been a weekly update for our trades. This is Kazi.
And Saeed.
We will see you guys in the next video. Until then, take care.